Hi, I'm John Friesen, and welcome to News 6. Today, News 6 is being presented by Mrs. Griggs' 6th grade class at Beaver Dam Middle School in Beaver Dam, Ohio. Not far from Beaver Dam is the city of Bluffton. Bluffton is the home of Bluffton College, and here's Annette Herr to tell us about the college's new Science Center.
Bluffton College has something most small town colleges don't have, an underground science building. The Shoker Science Center was finished in 1978. It was built into the side of a hill, so the rooftop is the level of the hill. The Shoker Science Center is a six-sided building. It is entered through the side that is open because of the way it was built into the hill. Inside there are many intriguing things. Among these are plant and animal species, which are fun to observe as well as educational. The center also has many labs and classrooms. There's also a large storage room which contains things like sheep eyes, sheep hearts, and many chemicals. But the most amazing things are the computers. They range in price from a few hundred dollars to $60,000. The computers have many uses like figuring the interest on a bank loan and typing letters in large numbers. The science building is very helpful to students. Bluffonites are very glad to have such a wonderful building in our town.
Thanks, Annette. Since Easter isn't too far away, it will soon be time for egg dyeing. Tina Herr has a story about a Bluffton lady who's very good at egg art.
Throughout history, eggs have had many different uses and meanings. A Bluffton resident, Mrs. Lois Witherall, does something unusual with eggs. She's involved in Pysanky, which is the name for Ukrainian egg dyeing. Mrs. Witherall recently gave us a demonstration of her craft.
I'd like to show you a method of coloring Easter eggs called Ukrainian egg decorating. It's called Pysanky, and it's been used by Ukrainian people for, a long time. First of all, you decide on a fresh egg what you'd like to do. It's very hard to get straight lines on a curved egg, so a good thick rubber band is a big help here. You take the rubber band and wrap it around the egg in a straight line, and then that becomes kind of a revolving ruler that you can use to mark off the egg. This is a special stylus called a Kiska, and it's filled with beeswax. Now, it needs to be hot so that the beeswax stays melted. There's a little hole in the bottom here. Can't be too hot, or it makes blobs, and then you just put it down and make your line. It's a very tedious, time-consuming process.
How'd you first get started in this?
Well, I've always liked to do lots of different kinds of crafts, and my dad had seen a Ukrainian egg kit that included the Kiska and a flat of beeswax, and a booklet that explained the technique. And I tried it and enjoyed it and have been working at it now for, probably four Easters. The people in the Ukraine do this more on a year-round basis, but then particularly at Easter as a part of their festivities.
Would it matter if you used hard-boiled eggs?
Yeah, you can't use a hard-boiled egg for this technique. The dyes are very intense colors, but it needs a smooth, fresh egg so that the dye will take the color evenly. And a boiled egg that's been in water for 10 minutes or so removes some of that natural oil from the egg, and then the dye might be spotty, or sometimes the eggs crack and then it wouldn't be usable. Okay, I have one here that's been completely done. The progression of colors is yellow, orange, light red, dark red, and then there's also a black. So that this egg has already been dyed in all of these colors. And when you're completely done and you think you're satisfied with the way it's turned out, then it needs to go into the candle flame enough till the wax is shiny, and then it can be wiped off. And then we can begin to see the design coming out. This is the most fun part, because after all that work, you begin to see how it's going to turn out.
Thanks, Mrs. Witherall. Recently, some of our class was given a tour of the offices of the Bluffton News, our local paper. During this tour, we learned how a newspaper is put together. Here's Sherry Bodicher with the story.
The Bluffton News in Bluffton, Ohio has been serving people from all over the world for more than 100 years. The circulation of the paper is 3,400 every week. In order to put the paper together, reporters are sent out as a first step to gather news items. Once all the items have been gathered, the editor writes the news. Then it's typeset on a computer typewriter, goes through a photoprocessor, and comes out on photographic paper. After proofreading, corrections are made and the story is laid out in the newspaper. The editor does the layout. It's then sent to Urbana, Ohio, where a negative is made. Then the negative becomes a plate. The plate is put on the printing press and paper is printed from the press. The newspapers are sent to other countries all over the world, like Canada, Japan, France, and Botswana.
Thanks, Sherry. Dr. B.W. Travis is a Bluffton physician who loves railroading. Here's Sonia Weaver.
Dr. B.W. Travis spent the early years of his life in Hannibal, Missouri. Not far from where he lived stood the tracks of the Missouri, Kansas, and Texas Railroad. The famous Wabash Cannonball came by on these tracks once a day. Dr. Travis has now lived in Bluffton, Ohio for the last 43 years. But he hasn't forgotten those trains in Hannibal. In his basement at home, Dr. Travis has an extensive model railroad. Dr. Travis, who has been active in model railroading for 40 years, used 1,500 feet of track in his setup. This corresponds to 12 miles of actual railroad. Dr. Travis explained that his railroad is unique because it is O gauge. Most people have the HO gauge. The O gauge is twice the height, length, and width of the HO gauge. Dr. Travis painted all the background scenery for his railroad himself. In front of the railroad, Dr. Travis operates a switching panel, which has a series of colored lights that match the couplings on the tracks. Every week during December, interested people can see Dr. Travis's railroad during special performances.
Thanks to Dr. Travis for showing us his trains. That's it for News 6 for today. Next week, News 6 will be presented by Ms. Stewart's class at Arcadia Elementary School in Arcadia, Ohio. Thanks for watching.